At 7 o'clock this evening, Eastern Time, air and naval forces of the United States launched a series of strikes against the headquarters, terrorist facilities, and military assets that support Muammar Gaddafi's subversive activities. From initial reports, our forces have succeeded in their mission. Several weeks ago in New Orleans, I warned Colonel Gaddafi we would hold his regime accountable for any new terrorist attacks launched against American citizens. More recently, I made it clear we would respond as soon as we determined conclusively who was responsible for such attacks. Today, we have done what we had to do. If necessary, we shall do it again.
On April the 16th, 1986, the United States Air Force struck at Colonel Gaddafi's nest of international terror. The principal target of the raid was the colonel's personal living quarters, and he very nearly died when his private sleeping area was blasted by a fighter flying out of the carrier Exeter. Call sign, Iceman 4. Well, the colonel survived, but he had a nervous breakdown. When he recovered, he vowed vengeance. Ironically, not just against the USA, but against Britain, because Britain had permitted the USAF F-111 strike bombers to operate out of our bases. The conduit he chose for his revenge was the Provisional IRA, and the method, a massive gift of weaponry to the terrorists. Well, London got to hear about it, and I'll call him Sam McCready of British Intelligence, had no choice but to send a man into the Middle East, as they say in the trade, a man in on the ground. The task was to find out exactly when and where that shipment would take place. The man McCready chose, let's call him Tom Rouse, had one characteristic so beloved of spymasters. He was totally dispensable. There was one major snag for Sam McCready. He was told that Rouse was an outcast of the intelligence community, and he was forbidden to go anywhere near him.
Sam, this office is bound by all directives issued by the security service.
Before you know it, we'll all find ourselves on television.
Oh, dear me. No, no, no. Look, we just absolutely do not use people in the media. I mean, obviously, one or two exceptions, Sam, all right. I mean, this guy, very low-grade, low-key guy who's churning out a living someplace, scribbling away at thrillers. Well, I mean, it's just out of the question. Sorry. No, I expressly forbid it. I can't give you any authority on this matter, none at all. But I suppose you'll decide for yourself precisely what risks are worth taking.
Thank you, Sir Robert.
Ah! Someone's come to buy a rug. Any special area you had in mind?
Area?
We've got Uzbekistan, Kurdistan, Baluchi, Bukhara.
Some new handloom rugs from the Panjshir.
So?
Oh, Panjshir, I think. Panjshir Valley.
You know, they started designing them with pistols and MiG-29s woven into the fabric.
Collector's items now. How much is this one?
700. 650 to you.
600.
For cash. Checks made payable to cash.
Drive a hard bargain, Tom.
You two know each other.
Nicola, this is Sam MacCready. Oh.
Are you a soldier?
Foreign and Commonwealth Office.
Well, you must stay for a drink.
Oh, that's very kind, but I must get back.
Oh, come all this way.
Maybe a quick walk with Tom. Short stroll in the evening air.
Sure. Won't be long, sweetheart.
Thanks. You're very busy right now.
Why?
I wondered if you'd might do a little job for my organization.
Not interested. Anyway, I'm on MI5's blacklist.
Task is Libya. IRA arms deal. I need to put someone on the inside track.
Good luck. Do you want to go for a drink? You must have people in Libya.
I really like it up here, in the peace and the quiet. No. No, you're the man we want. Chance to wipe the slate clean, Tom.
My slate's clean enough. I'm going back now.
Suit yourself. Oh, what's the man involved?
Mahoney.
Army, freeze! Get back! Mahoney!
No!
Leave the kid!
Mahoney.
No, not Mahoney, Tom. Terence Mahoney had an alibi. He and his wife were at a wedding. 22 witnesses, no less.
Still write to the child's mother.
I know you do.
Her grandpa was taking her to the circus.
Little kids like circuses.
I saw him push her.
Sinn Féin said she fell out. They wrote to her mother too. Full of regret.
So what's the job?
Different.
Bully, you old liar.
I hear you left the regiment.
I hear you started your own war.
Oh, when I was in prison, I read your book, Snipers.
Yeah, what do you think?
I smile sometimes. Some of these,
characters.
Right. They're not so fictional. You really don't like spooks, do you, Thomas?
Crazy guy. Why'd you throw those three Colombians away?
Well, they made my son a junkie.
But you lifted their $200,000.
Who do you think I am? Don Quixote? You want some beer?
Sure.
Come on.
Uli, suppose I need some stuff.
Dope?
No, arms. Some plastic, special items. Large quantity.
Vienna's the place. Crooked GRU man called Piotr Karyagin. Huh? He's tapped into Omnipol Special Projects Division. Tells the Czechs it's for the great struggle. Freedom fighters who can't be named. Pricey but efficient.
Plus I need to move it out of Europe.
Air or sea?
Air is difficult at the country of destination.
Is this for your next book?
Of course. Arms and certain Irish groups. And a plot to blow up the White House. All the usual stuff.
We should go to this club the IRA use.
Yeah?
British undercover cop was killed in the back room. Dumped in the alley right by the back door. Took some time, they say.
Yeah? Sounds like a fun place.
Bonsoir, ça va?
Oui.
Bonsoir.
Français?
Suisse, Genève. Bien.
Voulez-vous
de poule? Pourquoi pas? C'est Christine, c'est gratuit. C'est cher.
Oh, wow, wow, bro. Bier. Bier.
Champagne, darling. I only drink champagne.
You remember Colombian Nick and Esteban with the blue hat?
Sure, they got wasted.
I did it. That's four beers. All right?
Let's do it.
Dear sake, man, did you win the Falklands single-handed?
Qu'est-ce que tu passes anglais? Je sais assez bien me comporter.
Come off it, friend. You've got Brit written all over you. Plus, a mate of mine in there has seen you in Belfast. Plus, I've seen your photo on the inside of your books, Mr. Rouse. Every one of which I've enjoyed, I must say. So what are you doing in here? Research, is it?
No, I'm a wee bit nervous. I heard you took out a cop.
Not me, sir. John Joe, remind me to send you in a self-defense course. Well, it's not every day we get to meet an old sass man. Do you want your drink?
Sure.
Ulrich Kleist, you keep rough company. Your author friend here has disabled my bloody bodyguard. Right, Mr. Rise and me are off for a wee drink. See how Kleist gets what he wants on the house.
See you. I'll be fine. Thanks for the introduction. Bonsoir.
So what do you think of the band?
Very lively.
Are you wise?
I didn't know you could play.
Didn't your computers tell you that?
I didn't spend long in Ulster.
That book, Snipers, that was a bloody good read. See here, Kleist gets what he wants. So what were you doing in the club?
I'm writing another book.
About the Troubles?
I wouldn't presume. It's a thriller.
And you're including the organization?
I don't think so. It was Ulrich I was more interested in.
After wasting 3 dope barons, that fella's living in borrowed time.
Well, that's the angle. I suppose, I don't know, I suppose he thought me being ex-army, I'd be impressed. Rubbing shoulders with the IRA.
And were you?
I didn't ever find you people impressive.
You hated us?
Not even that. But that guitar, that impresses me.
Don't you patronize me, sass man.
You've broken a string.
Mr. Tom Rose.
Господин Корягин. Как вы поживаете?
Хорошо. Пошли. Вы говорите по-русски, господин Роуз?
Немножко. Если вы говорите очень медленно.
I don't believe I have to speak Russian slowly for you. My spies tell me you are fluent to interpret the standard.
Which spies would that be?
Your publisher, actually. It's on the publicity blurb for Sugarbush.
My publisher exaggerates, don't they all?
What can I do for you?
Well, this book I'm working on is to do with arms smuggling.
I heard it was to do with cocaine.
Who told you that?
Word gets around you've been moving in somewhat dangerous circles, Mr. Rose.
Major Carriagan.
No, thank you.
I want to know how to obtain the following.
Air-to-ground missiles, exploding briefcases, silenced pistols. What makes you think I would know?
I'd do my homework, Major. We wouldn't be sitting here if I hadn't heard you could help.
This is not for research, is it?
It's for my book. However, I do have a sort of fund for information.
This type of weaponry, Omnipod produces it, of course. They supply it to Warsaw Pact approved outlets. Mm. In your fiction, Who would be the customer?
Well, let's say a group of idealists who disapproved of the present U.S. administration.
This would be for use in Europe? Against U.S. bases?
In my fiction, in the United States itself. Perhaps even the White House.
My dear Mr. Rose, this is the age of glasnost. Maybe the Czechs who control Omnipol, they would love to help. But my own masters in Moscow out there, at the old Kodinka airport, they wouldn't countenance even clandestine sale of such arms to your American terrorists.
Fictional.
Fictional terrorists.
The person you want to see and talk to is a man called Saeed Jalloud. He's a member of the Libyan Security Directorate. Surprisingly, they're very good.
Good?
Professional.
Can you give me an introduction?
Absolutely not. I cannot be seen to help even a fictional group to operate in the United States.
Saeed Jalloud.
You like him? He went to eat?
One moment, please. Come this way, please.
Is there a problem?
This way. Just a few questions, Mr. Rouse.
James.
Date of birth?
June 11, 1952.
Occupation?
I'm a writer. I write books.
Reason for visit?
Look, I've got a visa.
You have a visa in. You do not have a visa out.
What the hell is this?
The truck is yours.
Trying to stop.
You're not welcome here, Mr. Rouse. You're a former officer in British Special Forces, and now you are a writer of satirical fiction. These two facts don't seem to constitute a very good reason for admitting you into Libya.
May I show you something?
Okay.
These, they're official reactions to my last book.
So?
The point is, sir, I'm detested by the English establishment. I constitute no threat to your country. All I want is a few days in Libya to research my next book.
I don't think the Libyan people would be too thrilled to be ridiculed by Tom Rouse. We don't have the English penchant for insult and betrayal. I'll walk you back to the airplane. We have a seat for you.
Here. To tell you the truth, I've read all of your three books. I'm quite a fan.
Oh, that's nice.
I have a small case.
Pardon?
I have a small case.
Oh, it's on the aircraft.
Is your name by any chance Jalud?
Saeed Jalud. You're well informed.
It seems so are you.
Where are you going next?
I'm kind of at a dead end.
In that case, my friend, why don't you fly on to Cyprus? Book into the Pavilion Hotel. It is most comfortable. And one can meet all sorts of interesting people there.
Hotel.
Oh, here.
Oh, thanks.
Any idea why they refused him entry?
Well, word is that Jalud himself put him back on the very plane he arrived in.
Damn! Damn! Damn!
Best laid plans, Sam.
Bloody damnation.
I must say, he's been laying a trail across Europe, making it very clear what he's after.
Oh, dear, I thought he knew how to play this game.
Using amateurs, you see? No wonder Five warned us off.
Oh, do shut up, Donald.
Pull him out.
No, not just yet. What have we got to lose? And I need a bath.
Well, I wasn't going to say.
Aperisto.
Madame?
Might one propose a toast?
That depends.
To tranquility and a breathtaking view.
I'll drink to tranquility.
You here on holiday?
Bloodstock. I buy racehorses.
In Cyprus?
Syria. I just paid $500,000 for 2 stallions. Would you like some champagne?
My cousin trains racehorses.
Who's that?
David Rouse, Newmarket.
Didn't he win the Derby 2 years ago? Blue Moth, out of Tomorrow's Land.
Oh, that's the fellow. I'm Tom Rouse.
Monica Brown, Anthony.
Hi.
Hi.
Where did you go in Syria?
Damascus and Hama. They have a big stud sale there. Except I was the only Western woman, so I got a little nerve-wracking.
You traveled alone?
My husband and his brother are with me, but they've gone back to Ashford.
I was wondering. I'm sorry.
No. Go ahead, please.
I was just wondering, maybe we could share a table.
Only if we go Dutch.
Bloody hell. He's ordered lobster now. This is just not on.
Making hay while the sun shines.
Boy, do I hate freelancers.
He's your choice, Sam. The man is your foundling.
Donald?
Oh.
Hey. I thought we were going Dutch.
Get out of here. That's all expenses anyway.
Well, thank you.
Well, you're welcome. Serves a major right for leaving me stranded.
Well, tomorrow night I pay.
Well, I'm not sure when you're here tomorrow night. The shipping agent, the guy who's shipping my horses back to London, I haven't made the final arrangements with him yet. Actually, I have to go. You're such a nice man, Tom. I think Nicole is a very lucky girl.
Nicole is, I keep telling her.
God bless you.
Much for willpower.
Don't tell me you got the same plane.
actually the next one.
Why did you expel me?
Oh, no, no, no. I just refused your entry because of information received.
You want to hear?
Received from this island, received from Vienna, received from a certain cheap nightclub in Hamburg.
What information?
Your friend in Hamburg, Kleist, told everything before certain animals put him out of his misery.
It's the drugged people that killed Ulrich. Colombians. Papers said they're Colombian drug barons.
Ulrich's killers do deal in heroin and cocaine, but their principal hobby is planting bombs in crowded places and failing in elaborate schemes to assassinate your British leaders.
Lynch. That bastard.
He took you home just to keep you out of the club. You English still see humanity in the people who hate you. I noticed this even at Eton.
I'll kill him.
No, you won't. You're far too sensible. Before he died, Ulrich said you were looking for equipment to be used inside the United States.
Okay, I'm listening.
$300,000 is chicken feed, Mr. Rouse, but that's not a big problem.
Well, a man in Vienna said you could help.
The biggest problem is precisely what you're playing at.
Jeez, I didn't have to kill Uli.
Oh, I think perhaps they enjoyed it. Ah, we have to go for a ride now.
Is this a ride from which one can expect a return?
It really depends on the answers to a few simple questions.
They're putting him into a car.
Excellent. At last, he's in play.
Suppose they kill him. Suppose he tells all.
Dear me, Donald, don't start caring about Joe's. For goodness sake, the man's merely on contract. He knows nothing of importance.
Who will you send in if Tom Rouse fails?
You, dear boy. Who else?
When were you promoted to captain?
Oh, let's get this straight. I've got 400 grand. I'm here to purchase a very small quantity of ordnance for a group of people, only one of whom I've ever met. They're paying me well, and I want the cash.
But you're a successful author.
Authors don't actually make much unless they strike it lucky.
What's your cut?
100,000.
Chicken feed.
It's not to me.
So, you don't want to talk about the special forces?
What can I tell you? You people are clearly very well informed.
We got ex-special forces working for us in the People's Jamahiriya.
Everyone has to make a living.
Okay, this contact. How'd they find you?
Soldier of Fortune magazine.
What issue?
March this year.
Saying what?
What words, son?
Armament expert with access to special equipment required for executive deal. Good commission, full details to, and a box number.
And you met him where?
Paris.
How many?
I met one man.
Age?
Young, early 20s, Ivy League, a yuppie.
A what?
A yuppie, Wall Street slang, Frank. Young, upwardly mobile person.
Okay, so what was this yuppie's name?
Did you people have Uli Kleist wasted? Was it you or the provost? I'd like to know.
Answer.
He called himself Pollard, Galvin Pollard. We met at the George Sank. He wasn't registered. I checked. Mr. Rouse, as I understand it, this yuppie paid you good money to obtain explosives, arms, and booby-trap devices in order to attack the fabric of American domestic society.
Affirmative.
Are there such people, Frank?
Sure. In a country that size, you get all kinds of cooks. I guess it's written into the Constitution.
And you believe they would attack the White House itself?
On the Senate. They were keen on the Senate. Claymore mined, they reckoned.
But they definitely said the White House.
Talk is cheap.
They seem pretty crazy, no serious ideology.
Then what on earth is a man like you doing dealing with such people?
The folding green stuff, Jalu. Come on, we'll get the weapons from someplace. Why shouldn't I make a bob or two?
Bob?
Shillings, Frank. English money. Obsolete. You can go back to your hotel now.
Even though I know where this place is. Your safe house.
It's just a holiday villa, son. Empty last night. We just borrowed it. Forced up a window. Remote and safe. When you go, we go.
Stay at the pavilion. I'll get in touch. What do you think, Frank?
I think he's doing it for the money.
If we supply the equipment, what about Trouse?
Once he passes it on to the crazies, might make sense to waste it.
An appropriate course. I'll talk to Kadhaf Kaim.
Yasu, I have some life assurance forms to be signed.
I don't know. I only work here.
Is the boss here?
He's upstairs. Go on up.
Thanks.
Sugar and milk?
Tea break at MI6. I love it.
Actually, I brought it with me from Washington.
Yeah, I heard they had none left in Boston.
Grover T. Fleming, U.S. State Department.
Give me some skin.
You really are exceptionally insolent, Tom. What happened?
They'll consider. I'm to stay put in the pavilion.
Where did they take you?
Up the panhandle. Turkish territory, rented villa. This really gross American was there to check me out. Aged about 50.
Glance over these pics.
No. That, him.
Frank Turpel, renegade CIA man, went over to the Syrians years ago. He's wanted stateside for treason.
That figures. He's way out of touch. But the Libyans seem to defer to his Western insight.
Did you convince him? Did Turpel believe you?
I think he believed they'd do anything for cash angle.
Yeah, Frank would.
Sam. It was the IRA that killed Ulrich Kleist. Tortured and killed him while I was away. Talk about being suckered. Listen, he's got a son.
How do you Kleist know?
Only my cover story. the boy's called.
Puts you in a strong position, Tom.
For Christ's sake, I didn't plan it.
Well, maybe not, consciously.
After all, you did leave him behind at the Blue Mouse Club. And swan off with Mickey Lynch.
Your people were there. And you did nothing.
My dear boy, we are not playing at this. Any further Irish sightings?
No.
Who is the girl you treated with lobster and chilled white wine?
Bloodstock dealer on her way back to England. She's American. Maybe Texan.
Name?
As if you didn't know.
Tom, I'm keeping well back. Don't want the very professional Jalud to sniff us out. You really are on your own right now.
Monica Brown. With an E.
If the Libyans agreed to supply your US crazies, tell them you intend to charter a freighter for shipment to Bremerhaven.
See, if the cards fall right, Jalud will suggest they include your consignment on a ship Sam and I believe they've already acquired.
We understand the IRA have huge arms and explosives gift from Gaddafi. He fondly imagines it'll be used to arm the Republican population and start an uprising in the six counties. In return, he makes them promise an outrage in London, something to repay us for Tripoli.
If you know so much, what am I doing here?
Well, we don't know which ship, or where, or when. And you are to find that out. Now, drink up your tea and get back to work.
Okay, but don't crowd me.
I would be nowhere near. Tom, Terence Mahoney flew into Cyprus this afternoon. He's staying at the pavilion.
Leave it, kid!
Now we're getting somewhere.
Won't he recognize you?
My cover's good. Ulrich Kleist sorted out.
With an E.
Hi.
Hi.
I thought maybe you'd gone.
No, I'll be here a couple of days yet. You get your horses fixed up?
Yeah. They're being flown in tomorrow. I'll put them on the boat and then take the plane back to London. Back to crowded streets and traffic jams.
Don't you just love England?
Sometimes.
Are you still on for dinner?
Tom?
Oh, sorry.
I said, yeah, I'd love to. Is everything okay with you?
Yeah, it couldn't be better. About eight?
I'm looking forward to it.
I didn't order that.
I don't believe it. I don't actually believe this. He's ordered lobster again.
At least he's earning it now.
There's Mahoney. Chicken and rice for them, I see.
Why didn't you tell me you were a famous writer? Well, I'm fascinated.
I'm not at all famous, not really. Wish I was.
The major reads a lot. I'm into more factual stuff. Like sailed around the world by yourself, or I enjoyed that book about the couple that sailed around the world nonstop in that kind of motorized paper airplane.
Do you ever read anything about people who go halfway around the world?
Oh, I don't actually believe in going halfway, Tom.
Oh.
You miss Nicola?
I haven't even thought about her.
Must be true love.
Oh, I do love her. I've been up to my eyes in work.
Come on, writers don't really work.
Thanks a lot. No, I do love Nicolette. Her husband was my best friend.
What happened?
Oh.
to. Hear me?
You know that fella?
Best man at his wedding.
Not a job, but...
It was an automobile accident.
Ooh, poor girl.
And afterwards, I helped her pick up the pieces, in a manner of speaking.
Are you all right?
Sure.
So you fell in love?
That's exactly what happened. How do you meet the Major?
Oh, wild ball at a country house.
A wild ball?
Yes, a wild ball at a country house. A couple of hoorays decided to rip my dress off and throw me in the goldfish pond. Major Brown with an E knocked him off flat. Then he picked me up in his arms, put me in his Bentley, and drove me home directly. We got married 3 weeks later.
You know, if I wrote that, people wouldn't believe it. Listen, Monica, I have to go into Nicosia tonight on business. I'd ask you to come, but it's really boring.
I can take a hint. This was really good, thank you.
Thank you.
Where's Frank?
Hey, we don't parade Frank too much in public, Mr. Ross.
Zero.
Colonel Gaddafi is graciously pleased to make a contribution to your clients, the defenders of democracy.
They'll be grateful to him.
The Colonel believes in the defense of democracy.
Sure.
He's agreed to everything.
How much?
Oh, no. From the People's Jamahiriya, a gift. However, since you, Mr. Rouse, are going to be 400,000 better off, I suggest we split it 50-50, you and me.
Can you give me a receipt for 300 grand?
Don't be absurd. Where precisely can you take delivery?
Tripoli, Benghazi, Tobruk. I can charter a freighter here, secure skipper and crew.
Then what? Sail through the Atlantic?
Bremerhaven. I can air freight the stuff from there to the West Indies and I have a safe route into the USA.
I think I can help you. There is a possibility I can arrange shipment if your cargo goes directly to Bremerhaven.
How?
I can let you know tomorrow. It would be more secure if my own organization controlled the movement of such sensitive material.
Just so long as it doesn't come out of my cut.
Oh, spoken like a true entrepreneur. You know the man at the bar?
Don't think so.
He's a freedom fighter, too. He seems to think your face is terribly familiar.
Maybe he's read one of my books. It's on all the back covers.
Of course. Well, I must press on. You have no idea how busy I am these days. And this is for you.
Yasu.
Andaxi.
Andaxi, absolutely. Super Andaxi. Aparisto, Yasu.
You really can't be bloody rude, you know.
Don't look at me.
Don't you have people who do this sort of thing?
Gets damn boring hopping from committee to committee. So?
Okay. Jalloud says yes. Jalloud says Gaddafi says yes. Everything on my shopping list. Rifles, pistols, Semtex explosives, mines, letter bombs, a lot. Oh, yes. And 5 ground-to-air missiles with user manuals. Jalloud says no to me getting a ship. He'll try to get it freighted on, quote-unquote, an existing vessel. Mahoney's in there with him right now, so it's safe to assume that will be our target freighter.
How does Mahoney feel about you being in the frame?
He's clocked me. He's been told by Jalloud, I think, to mind his own business, but that's kind of a danger zone, quite frankly.
When will you know?
Tomorrow.
Grab some sleep. You look terrible.
And you don't.
Open. Just go on inside.
Who the hell are you?
That's the very question I'm just about to put to you. Go on in. Bit of a mind reader, old boy. Inside.
And in order room service.
So what's your game then?
What's it to you?
Survival, Mr. Rex. That's what it is to
me. Why pick on me?
Sit down. What were you doing with Saeed Jalloud?
Giving him a few tips on roulette.
I know all about you, Tom Rouse. And about your trashy novels. It's no wonder you people never understood us. You should really stop struggling. I know about your past history, sass man. And I know you've been travelling around Europe and the Middle East looking for arms for some unheard-of bunch of Americans. So I can figure out why you were talking about Jalloud. Question is, pal, can you be trusted? And why do I keep thinking I've seen you somewhere before?
Who the hell are you?
We're just a few men out on a couple of days' holidays. There's a lot of people who'd like to spoil it for us. And your government is top of the list.
Like, you're paranoid. I mean, what did you find?
Nothing you didn't want us to. Has Jalloud agreed to talk?
I can't discuss Jalloud.
And why do I think I've seen you somewhere before?
You'll never know if your pal here strangles me.
Ease off. Why?
It's Belfast. I did 3 tours.
With the SAS?
Paratroops. Never did go there with the other lot.
So what's this crazy story about Americans looking for arms?
Look, I mind my own business. You mind yours, okay?
You're in no position to make deals, man.
Take it or leave it.
I know your face, though.
Freeze!
You probably saw it on the back of a book cover.
Maybe I did. Maybe I did. Come on. I'm putting you under a microscope, pal. If you're fooling around, I'll take you out.
Yes.
Boy. When you writers throw a party.
Aye.
What exactly happened?
There's 3 guys I met in a bar downtown.
We started discussing politics.
I've seen worse. Major's always getting himself into fights. Now, Mr. Rouse.
Yes?
I'm not a girl to throw herself at a fellow. But you look awful. Your room's wrecked. Your bed's a shambles. I got a wonderful muscle in him, and it's very good. We use it on the horses. And a big double bed, just one flight up. You're welcome to both. With or without the present incumbent.
A woman of so shining loveliness that men thresh corn at midnight by her smile.
There's corn and there's corn. But I like a man who knows his Yates.
Someone help me.
Quite a gentleman for such a macho kind of guy.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And it wasn't smile Mr. Yates wrote. It was dress.
Oh. Mm-hmm. A little stolen dress.
Major's a great Yates man.
Well, that's just great.
Always quoting away. And pluck till time and times are done. The silver apples.
Silver apples of the moon, golden apples of the sun.
Took your bloody time reporting this, didn't you?
I fell asleep in the bath.
Dear, oh dear.
This is a military operation.
Military, is it?
You know what I mean.
Incidentally, how much life insurance have you people provided for me?
Hmm? This is not the moment to be discussing administration.
Sam, I'm in between a rock and a hard place. Mahoney's proved himself to be a fully functioning bad guy. If he finds out what I'm playing at, he'll make sure I don't see Christmas.
You let a cowardly little creep like Terry Mahoney bother you?
Sure.
Say, man, I know this is none of my business, but shouldn't you have sorted out Tom's contract earlier than this?
He knows our terms. Our short-term contracts are fairly standard.
I want $100,000 insurance for Nicola if anything happens to me.
Sam!
I really have no intention of discussing this.
Just say yes, Sam, to the insurance, that's all.
Tom, I'll look into it, believe me, but it's not in my gift. I'll have to speak to London.
Fine. I'm going back to the hotel now. If I don't hear from you by 4 o'clock, I catch the evening flight for England. Grover, nice meeting you.
So long, man.
What are you gonna be when you grow up, Sonny?
The boy's hurting. Why don't you just say yes?
Because I never lie to my agents.
Oh, Sam. Why is your nose getting longer?
But if he quits, it's goodbye. No insurance. No expenses, and not a bloody penny for those bloody lobsters.
Maybe everyone's getting strung out.
Mr. Rose, telephone.
Tom Rose here.
Hello. You know who this is?
Yes.
Good. Listen, I've arranged shipment. Go back to England immediately. You will be contacted at your charming cottage in the countryside 3 days before the cargo is due for collection at that European port.
Where precisely do I collect it?
The cargo will be taken to a warehouse, and this is important. It must be collected that same day. It cannot be left for even one night. Or It will be removed and the deal is off.
Understood. Where is the warehouse?
You will be told.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you've got a ship. What?
Bags all packed, I see. Good afternoon.
Give me a number in England.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Why ever not? But it was a fling, you said so.
You're right. Let's leave it at that.
Thing or not, I'll find you.
You don't even know me.
I know you very like me, Monica Brown, with an E.
Is it just a shipboard romance on dry land? Let's leave it at that. Be good.
McCready says you win. He telexed London from the High Commission. They're giving you $100,000 insurance cover as from today.
You mean sod.
He worries about you.
Hey, you tell me something. Where precisely does the U.S. government fit in?
Libya. Ground-to-air missiles. We have information. One of their missiles is airmarked to take out the U.S. ambassador in London.
The IRA needs U.S. support. They wouldn't dream of it.
It's Gaddafi's price for supplying them with a shipload of arms. Mahoney's already subcontracted the job, so some European group will take the blame.
And U.S.-UK relations go down the tube. Very neat.
Tom, I said you got your insurance, man. There's no need for you to take that plane.
Oh, yes, I do. Jalud phoned. The deal's on. Keep smiling. Bye, Spry.
What does he want now? We need
Spry, what are you going to do when you grow up?
Sam left explicit instructions before he left for London. I've given you my keys. All right. Badly as usual. We sold any rugs?
Yeah, the strangest thing. The day after you and McCready left, a couple arrived out of the blue and bought the entire lot, paid cash, £14,000.
Oh, that's nice.
They said they'd send for the merchandise, but it's still in the barn.
Oh, well, well. Hence the limo.
Yeah, come on.
Okay.
Okay.
How did you know I was arriving?
Your friend phoned.
With Sam?
Hmm.
Well, he's not such a bad old sod after all.
I heartily concur, sir.
Sam, what's with the disguises all of a sudden?
Change of life, I expect. Now, this is on the firm. We're putting you up at one of the Knightsbridge apartments and be ready at 8 sharp. Both of you.
Both of us?
Sure thing. I'm taking you to dinner, courtesy Her Majesty's government.
Ooh, woo.
I brought your best suit up.
I saw that. You're a pal.
Tommy?
Missy?
Is everything all right?
Sure.
What exactly are you doing for the government?
Nothing terribly exciting, just arranging a contract for them, that's all.
Darling?
What?
I've been an ambassador's daughter long enough to know not to ask awkward questions. But it's not dangerous, is it? Swear it. Swear it. After Peter.
I swear it.
Ah, this way. Thank you.
I'm surprised you're not having lobster, darling. It's his favorite.
I know.
I just fancied the duck, that's all. The swine is superb.
Oh, nothing but the best for our best and most honorable friend.
What on earth did Tom do to win such a prize?
Oh, it's not won yet, but he's working very hard to clinch it.
Ah! Excuse me.
Sam's earned the lobster, too.
Oh, really?
You better believe it.
Sam, prudent move of yours?
What's that? Oh, wow. This is divine.
Having a couple of babysitters along.
What, in this place? Are you mad? We could build a destroyer for the price of a meal in this place.
So who's the couple taking such a keen interest?
Oh, rubbernecks, tourists. Just soaking up the genuine clientele.
I mean, two pros, man and a woman, sitting by the bar in the corner. They're covering us. Nicola, don't look.
You two grow up.
You're quite right.
The world isn't full of spies, you know.
Well, unfortunately, my dear, mine is. The man over there is one Wolfgang Rutter. He's a lawyer. He's also a leading member of a terror society called the West German Revolutionary Cells, who've assumed the mantle of the Bader Meinhof.
And the woman?
Not known to me, but they are very professionally keeping an eye on us.
Well, all we're doing is having a meal.
Well, unfortunately, Rutter will check me out, and he'll learn that good old, bad old Tom here is dining courtesy of British intelligence.
Does it matter?
Nikki, I have just provided your loved one with 100,000 life assurance. I have no wish to pay it out.
So use the phone, get Special Branch to pull them in till our business is over.
I'd love to, but that would probably scotch the entire enterprise.
Very neat. You notice when we asked for our check, Rutter got up and left.
The girl waited to follow us, just in case we skipped out through the kitchens.
Tom, what is going on?
What's the plan, Sam? Give him the slip?
There's too much at stake for that. Too much at risk. Tom, under your seat. VIP protection drill, remember?
Yep.
When?
Whenever. Rutter, freeze.
Who's the boss?
Line 613, please. 13, this is a Phase 9 call. My name is Mulberry. Good evening to you. I have a Phase 9 requiring immediate attention. Battersea Park, north side, adjacent pagoda. Two items of laundry for collection, most urgent. Thank you. Thanks, Jerry, and make it fast.
It's all right. Nicola needs medical attention.
It's on its way. We've got to cover those two. I've got some blankets in the back. Tom?
You bastard.
That does not help, and may I remind you that you're still working for me.
Nikki.
Special branch.
Thanks, Jeremy. Good night.
Good night.
Not bad. 17 minutes from my first call. Here's your jacket.
They'll still be warm then.
I pulled a gun on you.
And you?
Go back to the apartment, Tom. Down to the cottage in the morning. You're expecting a call from Jalud. Remember?
What sort of person are you? Two people dead. Two people Jalud knew were trailing me. How are we going to explain their sudden disappearance?
The office can handle that. The night staff have already got their documents and wallet. We're very able in that department.
And how can you justify two...
Go on, say it.
Two murders.
Okay. Now you just listen to me, sonny boy. We're not just talking a shipload of guns and explosives here. We're talking misery to the power of whatever you like. Old women and wee boys torn limb from limb to satisfy some blood-bolted psychos whose only cause is the cause of ego-tripping power at the point of a gun.
If you and I had been born on the Falls Road, Sam, which side would we be on?
I was. And I'm on the side of humanity. Heaven help me.
Nicola, it's me.
Yes, what do you want, Tom?
Well, to take you home, of course. What's the matter?
I'm not going back to the cottage.
Look, you're still upset.
Tom,
Nikki, I had no choice. The man was shooting at me.
It's all going to end just like it did before.
No. Nikki, I love you.
Tom, don't phone me again.
Nikki.
Hello?
Mr. Thomas Rouse?
Speaking.
Are you alone?
Oh, yes.
Then I am coming to see you.
Who is...
I'm Abdul Salim. I bring a message from my father.
Your father? The man you met with Frike in Sampras? Don't you see a family resemblance?
Jalud.
Abdul Salim Jalud. Youngest but best loved son.
Marhaba, Labez?
Allahu Ndalala.
What can I offer you? My house is your house.
Thank you, Al Barakat. I won't stay. Your merchandise. Your merchandise will be at Warehouse, Neuwuk, Bay 09. Van Roslin, Straße, Bremerhaven.
Warehouse Neuwerk, Bay 09, okay.
Please be there in 3 days' time.
The 14th?
It will be there for 1 day only.
I understand.
Good luck.
And you?
Victory to the people's Jimahira.
Absolutely.
The young lady's expecting you.
Thanks. Don't you ever catch cold?
Oh, I get plenty of exercise.
Come on, Alice. Step through the bloody looking glass.
It can't be in Bremerhaven in 4 days, unless it's a bloody speedboat. And they haven't even been near the harbour, Mahoney and his boys.
It's the 14th, it's quite definite.
Look, sailing time, Cyprus to the Libyan coast, a good 24 hours. Allow 1 day, preferably 2 nights, to load, and 2 days to steam up through the Straits of Gibraltar to the Emerald Isle and offload the main cargo, and another day and a half to Bremerhaven. Damn it, Tom. It'll take 6 or 7 days from departure. And Mahoney's still in the Pavilion Hotel, and not one of those boys has even spoken to Jalud again. Or any known Libyan agent, and believe me, we know them all.
Well, 4 days out of Bremerhaven puts them about here, which is Libya. Presumably, Jalud's message coincided with the commencement of loading.
Well, without Mahoney?
Why not? How many watchers are on Mahoney and his team?
Entire Cyprus station, intelligence corps backup, plus some CIA from Rome. I tell you, Tom, they can't even cough without us knowing.
Beautiful.
I'm glad you're impressed.
Beautiful. Sam, say Terry Mahoney is a decoy.
Oh, don't be
leading absurd. Teams of watchers around by the nose while someone else completely different arranges the ship and sails quietly out of Famagusta for Benghazi. With luck, you'll still be telling Mahoney when the arms have been safely offloaded in Ireland and in Bremerhaven.
Do you see any other faces on your travels?
Mahoney, Mickey Lynch and Co. in Hamburg.
Where he remains, as of this morning.
I'd have told you, Sam.
I'll send over the picture book, Sally, going back to the year dot. Ah, it's back to the old rogues gallery, I'm afraid.
Oh, hell, I don't know. I've gone through this lot 3 times now. All the boyos I've ever seen are here, but none in Cyprus.
One more time.
Okay.
Oh,
Rosie's going to speak to Nicola. I mean, the girl had a dreadful shock.
I'm Look, sure... chum, I'll do this because we have a contract, but don't interfere with my... life. Nobody interferes. All right?
Sure.
That's him.
Who?
This old boy. Take his moustache off and he was there.
Where?
At the Blue Mouse in Hamburg. He was sitting with the chap at the bar. And at the airport in Libya, he got off the same plane as me. Passed through immigration, two in front.
Tom, you're exhausted. Grab some...
That's the man! Look! Earlobes, nostrils, eyes... I know!
That is a photo of one Stephen Johnson. The man is old and non-operative. Big noise once upon a time, chief of staff no less. Chucked out of the organization years ago. Total non-entity now, sells agricultural machinery in County Clare.
Non-entity.
Just so.
Persona non grata, shunned by his own side. Just who does that remind you of?
You're a good man, Thomas Rouse, despite the prima donna. Our friend Mahoney is the proverbial red herring. Could it be Johnson's the man we're after?
Sally, check with the Garda Síochána in Dublin Castle and G2 Intelligence Liam Mulgrew. Inquiry this. Stephen David Johnson. Is he in his usual haunts? If not, where? And so on and so forth. Thanks. Not seen in Limerick area. Been spending a few days in Spain from time to time. Returned with tan. Said he was going golfing.
Great.
Sally? Spanish counter-terrorist office, Madrid, plus immigration. Check if our friend has been golfing in Spain this year.
Johnson not sighted Spain past 3 years. No trace immigration, no trace police surveillance files.
Sir, do you want me to stay on? Only it's getting late.
Will you mind? It looks like being an all-nighter.
Oh, all right. I'll phone Nigel, ask him to make his own bloody supper.
Atta girl. Right. We'll just get Spry in Cyprus to run a check. But a pound to a penny, Johnson's our man.
The subject did in fact arrive by regular air flight in Cyprus 10 days ago. Our good senior police friends just made exhausting checks. The man moved out of his hotel. Figures about 2 days ago. But he's certainly not left the island by any scheduled air or shipping line.
How you doing, partner?
Yeah, what you got?
We got... You hungry?
Yeah.
I'm starved. Let's grab some chow.
Okay. Yeah.
We got a surveillance aircraft up over the Med, checking out every coaster, tramp, and freighter moving from Libya to the Straits of Gibraltar. I tell you, it'd be easier for a camel, etc.
Maybe some fried egg and sausage.
Yeah, I could taste it. We got satellite photographs from the NSA with details so fine you could read the print on a matchbox.
You have them here?
They'll be coming in all day. They won't be a floating cork we don't ID by nightfall.
And how do we know which one is?
Oh, we can't do that. What do you want, magic?
Well, some fried egg and sausage, that's what I want.
A boat. Another boat.
What did I tell you? These photos are bizarre.
I didn't realize how hungry I was.
Yeah, I need my cholesterol, baby. Hey, grab an eyeful of this. Tighter, Harry.
Closer.
Closer for my pervert friend.
That's Monica.
What, the lobster lady?
Monica Brown with an E. Could you carry horses on that freighter?
I don't know.
What ship?
Regina. Regina, Hamburg. You want more photos?
Oh, yes.
I can get this one computer enhanced, Tom.
No, that's him. That's Stephen Johnson. You bastard, you knew.
I didn't know, Tom. I figured she could have been.
What the hell is this? This man has no access to the services premises. Have you taken leave
of
your senses?
He's with me. Grover T. Fleming, United States State Department. President's Foreign Intelligence Office. Mr. Rouse is a special agent working for the state on matters of high security classification. I would be grateful if you would vacate the room, sir. You could compromise a need-to-know operation.
Young man, I am the...
Do bugger off, Andrew.
I'll see you later.
Thanks, Grover.
Okay. We need to take the Regina. Hmm? Can we involve the Royal Navy?
You can involve anything you want, Tom.
And can I run the capture?
Oh, you can plan it. A serving officer will require to run it. Someone from the Special Boat Squadron, I'd suggest.
Okay. Surveillance to continue, including radio eavesdropping and by submarine. She'll drop off arms and explosives to the Spanish Eta and French groups before running for Southern Ireland.
You sound sure.
Well, they foxed me once. Not this time.
How soon? The Blaskets.
15 hours. Maybe less. Ah. We've got a craft in distress here.
What are you doing?
See what I can do.
What is going on?
Boat in a bit of trouble. We can't stop.
And we're not gonna either.
It's a law of the sea. It could be us wrecked one day.
Just sail right on by, friend. Just sail right on by.
Sure. So shoot me. Who gets you to the Blasket Islands? In the dark.
Come on, fella. We can't take these guys on board. Look what we're carrying.
So we drop them, medical supplies and food, and the dinghy.
Sure. Why not?
Medical supplies and food. Get back! Get back! Get
me. She knew the name of the game, Tom.
Game?
Some bloody game. Us people, son.
Us people.
Who
was she?
A casualty of war, sir. Just like yourself.